In this video, I will be showing you how to install an IDE for running your Rust projects. So I will be using IntelliJ IDEA, and although it's an IDE for JVM, it supports plugins for Rust, and we will see how to install those plugins and make this IDE ready for creating and running Rust projects. You can also use cargo run for running your projects, and cargo new, and some options to create the projects, and cargo check, and many other options. And you can use your favorite text editor for that. But I find it much easier to work in an IDE. So I will be using this. And so just Google for install IntelliJ IDEA, and you will be directed to this page. And here you can download it as per your system requirement. So you will see ultimate and community versions. So this is for commercial purpose, and it's not free. You can download the community edition. So you can go ahead. So since my system is Mac, it shows me the default DMG. So you can download it from there. So once you have downloaded, so I went ahead and installed it. So when I open IntelliJ IDEA, you will see an option to create new project. So initially, when you create a new project, you will see that Rust is not listed here. So I cannot create a Rust project using this IDE. So first we will go here, and we will go to plugins. And then we will search for Rust. So you can see that Rust is here. So you can go ahead and install it. And it's by JetBrains, the same company behind this IDE. So you can install it. So you need to restart IDE for it to take effect. So let's restart. And now you should see the option to create a Rust project. So we will go ahead and create a new project. So you see here Rust is added. So you can create a Rust project. And these fields are already filled because I have already installed Rust on my system. So I want to create a binary application and not a library. So I will select this option, and I will select next, and I will name my project Hello World. And finish. So it will show the tips. You can skip it or go through it. And now you see here a Hello World project. And when you expand it, you can see a TOML file. So first time you open this TOML file, you will see that the syntax is not highlighted, and it gives you an option to install plugins for TOML. So you can install that, and it will again restart. You need to restart for it to take effect. So let's restart it. And now you see that it's also properly highlighted. So these keys are in orange and these values are in green. So this is specify the package details, your project details, like authors, version, and the project name. And then in the source, you will see your main Rust file with Hello World here. So this is the default you will get. So let's go ahead and run it. So we have not created any configuration, so it we will run this hello world, and you can see some warning messages because it complains of a snake case because I had named it hello world. It prefers this kind of naming, so you can name your project like this. And you can see here the output is printed here. So let's change the output and let's run again. And you see that the output is accordingly updated. And so it's very easy to create a project or run the project from this IDE rather than using cargo and command line tools. So that was all for installing IDE. So in next video, we will start looking into more features of Rust programming language. See you in the next video.